That is not where time starts. But no, I had a lot of fun playing Dark. I'm very excited to play some normal now. I also want to go into 100% sometime. Honestly, I might route like all relics sometime, because all relics seems a lot more fun than 100%. But yeah, 100% is on the horizon. I'd love to go for like the clean sweep on these, because it's most of the categories are just done by one guy, and I'm pretty sure they're all his first runs. So we'll need to see how long that takes to fall. So far, just beating this game on any difficulty other than easy, though. It's pretty tough, I won't lie. Decided to play through handheld Legend of Spyro. This is super fun. Temper your expectations for the other one, though. It is not as good as this one. But still, you know, you can have some fun with it. But it's a very different game. Every Spyro game. That's a good goal to set. I've almost beaten every Spyro game now, at least in like an any percent run style of thing. The only games that I'm missing are Hero's Tale and all the DS games. And Reignited, of course. I really want to sit down and like learn a Hero's Tale, even if not like get competitive at, just at least learn the route of. Oh no, I've not also not touched any of the mobile stuff. That's a little off my radar, I won't lie. Even for me. Dark gems? That sounds like fun. I assume 40 dark gems is like the main requirement to beat the game. Did I change the game to German by accident? Oh, Deutsch is not Dutch, it's German. Oops. You guys are getting a German playthrough now. Because I am just a useless Brit. Uncultured. I can't believe I set the language to German, not Dutch. That's ridiculous. Oh my gosh. It's really no surprise this game looks as good as it does, because it was actually one of the last Game Boy Advance games ever. So there was no, no surprise in that the game, they knew how to work with the hardware. And this was a Maze, the company that did, they did a lot of Game Boy Advance titles. They did Shrek Super Slam, Crash the Titans. Yeah, 2007. So the DS had already been out for what, 2 years or something? Oh, I forgot, you can just kind of cheese this guy. Let's go. Yeah, no, this is Game Boy Advance. It's crazy. Nice damage boost. Hey, if I'm getting a thing on the ice world now, that means I get increased defense for, like, the rest of the run. We take those. We super take those, oh my gosh. Did I get the strength upgrades? Like, both of them? Yeah, I definitely did. Yep, the language is definitely wrong. Anyway, onto the Earth Temple. Oh, my best segment's a 420, let's go. I'm afraid we're not allowed to bop this, legally. I've gotta wait on the boss. So far you 100%ed 1, 2, 3, ETD, Hero's Tale, Season of Ice, and A New Beginning on console. Nice! If you're doing 113 on Fusion, let me know, because it's dumb. I've done it a lot of times and it's very dumb. If you want the real completion of Fusion, then there's also a lot of like extra stuff you need to do, which it still caps at 113%, but you get a new like title screen. 200 cards. If you're doing that on console, make sure you've got two copies of Spyro Fusion and two copies of Crash Fusion. You need two. You can't get all 200 cards with only one of each. It's physically impossible. Because there's one card that you can only get by connecting two copies of Crash Fusion together, and there's one card you can only get by connecting two copies of Spyro Fusion together. Without that, you'll only get 98. There's also two cards in Spyro Fusion that you can only get by entering a cheat code on the main menu. That's fun. Crash Fusion also has cards you can cheat for, but those aren't mandatory. You can collect those in the game. There's also a chance when you're linking consoles together that during the trade sequence it will fail for no reason and you will lose the card. It'd be like if the Pokemon trade half failed halfway through and the Pokemon was just gone. It also sucks for cards that you can only get one of, like boss cards. So 200 cards isn't technically full completion. You also need to... Well, it is if you do the game glitchless. If you do the glitch route to get all the cards, then you will only end up with like 87%, sorry, 78%, even with all 120 from one copy. When it would normally be 113. So you need to make sure that you do every minigame three times, as that adds to your percentage counter. But I would also recommend doing, when you're doing 200 cards, doing it with some sort of guide. The game is really cryptic at times on how to do things. For example, one minigame, it just looks like a, oh, collect as many gems as you want style minigame. But no, you need to collect specifically 100 to actually, like, finish the minigame. Yeah, if you're doing a glitch list, that's okay, you've got nothing to worry about. Just collect all the cards and you'll be fine. I will never not find it funny, though, how many glitches are in the Spyro Fusion, especially compared to Crash Fusion, which has, like, nothing. You do not need to speak the magic to me. I was there when it was written. Okay, that was fine. Okay, full health, that's all good. 2 minutes for Naga, that sounds about right. And then on ice, I need to remember and do the alternate route. Okay, that wasn't too bad. Anyway, ice time. I thought the game softlocked for a moment there. I didn't see any movement on screen. Okay, let's see if I can get this down. No, darn it. Okay, he fell down. That's probably the best thing that could have come out of that, actually. I was really hoping for some health pickups out of that. Didn't get any, but let's see. Let's hope this goes well. I need to remember to take care of the frogweed. Frogweed's gonna cause more problems than anything else. So I'll deal with him first. There we go. And onto the ice world. So, this is going to take a bit more time because we're going to be picking up an extra power-up. But, it'll save time in the long term because I'm going to die less. Alright, first things first. Very nice. Back to full health, exactly what I wanted, and pretty much exactly where I wanted as well. Oh, I need to still be on ice breath here. This. And now I need to swap off Ice Breath for here. That's ice for you. Okay, round two versus the ice boss. And we should heal leaving here. I kind of need to deal with the wizard first, to be honest. He's more in the way. Way more than the other guy. Okay. On to the boss. Okay. Not terrible. Significantly not terrible. Question is, can I get through the next room without dying? Maybe I'll check the crystals up top and heal up. That'll probably be for the best. Oh, the crystals aren't here anymore. This is a different room, it seems. Okay, I'm just gonna die here, I think, and respawn. Okay, we're out of there. On to Scott. Cool, so I can fit about two combos in. Oh my gosh. Okay, should just be one more cycle or so. Run it. Oh my gosh, hit the other way. Okay, we're out of there. Onto the temple. All going all right so far. Let's see how far we can take this. Not bad. Oh my gosh, charge please. Okay, don't have as much health for this fight as I'd like. We'll just play it safe, get a bunch of cycles in. Oh my gosh, never mind. We are super duper dead. There's like a 0% chance this works out. Because of stuff like that. Oh, that wasn't really even worth trying. Okay. Round 2 versus the lightning boss. We have a lot more health this time. Okay, it's pretty much just one more hit on this guy now. Okay, we have one more defensive upgrade to go. And then hopefully that's going to help a lot with the advisor fights. Swap device here. Snail didn't spawn. Die here. That's fine. Swap it to the ice breath again. Up and over, fantastic. Very nice, like all the despawns. He just does so much damage, even with this, like, extra defense. Okay. Round two. I was meant to turn around, then lightning. No. Yes, let's go. Let's go. Yo, Pruny, what's good? You remember this game? I hope so. It's all been streaming the last three, like, couple days. Anyway, let's see if we can get a good advisor. That looked about right. Hey, it gives us another go though. Okay. We're pretty much there. I just missed up a few, like, crucial bits, pretty much. So I unfortunately got scammed by these opening early. Yeah. Oh, I'm feeling like we're so close to finally getting him here. Nice. That is not how you want the first few seconds of this to go. Okay, I hate Advisor 3, and I've got Fury, and Fury can be used to heal, but I would need to save that for the final boss. Because healing is not an option during the final boss, whereas at least here, like, I have some health pickups I can get if I'm absolutely needing it. Whatever, I'll just use this here. No, he's not gonna kill me after that. No. Okay. Yo, Fuman, what's good? Thank you. So here I'm recharging my Fury. I just want to get this bar that's surrounding the lightning right now back to full. This is the only chance I have of really defeating this guy. Let's see if we can get sub 1. I forget how tough Gaul is, but heck. Farming points make me do stuff? Aw, oh, heck. I'm gonna need to increase the cost of some of these things, aren't I? But basically, if I die here, I'm gonna go back to the main menu and then reload the save. Because that way I won't have to replenish my Fury gauge. That's fine. That was expected. Okay. Question. Could someone go on speedrun.com and check what the normal world record is? Because I thought it was an hour and a half, and I'm starting to doubt myself. Heck, the 5506. Yeah, any percent GBA. The 1 hour 59, we beat it by an hour, boys, let's go! This run is world record by a lot. You were here, chat.